morning to you all. I would like to welcome you to the last event of the FinaBit project. I would like to specially thank our two more distant guests, Ben Fine, by my side, and Manuel Alberts, for having accepted our invitation to be here today, as well as the local and global speakers of today. This conference, as mentioned, is the last event of the FinaBit project that brought together a team of researchers from the Center for Social Studies of the University of Coimbra and the Institute of Geography and Spatial Planning of the University of Lisbon. This project aimed at studying the relation between finance and housing provision in Portugal over the last four decades. And by studying housing provision in this small peripheral country, FinaBit endeavored to contribute to bring financialization studies into the knowledge of understudied geographies. At the time we put together the application of this project, financialization was a rapidly expanding field of research comprising distinct research agendas devoted to the analysis of different aspects of contemporary capitalism. But we felt then that there was not enough attention to peripheral or smart peripheral geographies. Thus, by looking into the Portuguese case, we aim to broaden and deepen the analysis of the reach of finance within existing and new actors and territories. This micro focus, of course, is not particularly innovative. The study of Portugal as a micro country has a long lineage, and in our research center, several colleagues of ours, including Gilberto Reis, who will be with us here today, have some time ago worked on the concept of periphery to account for the intermediate nature of the socioeconomic structures producing heterogeneities and dysfunction. This included relevant mismatches between forms of capitalist accumulation and forms of social reproduction, distinguishing itself from the institutional arrangements associated with the forest accumulation regime, as well as from regional disparities. But we still feel that the concept of small peripheral continues analytically relevant to account for the specificities of the present financialized forms of contemporary capitalism in Portugal, which explains the title of the conference of today. FinaBit explicitly adopted a political economy approach, placing the study of housing provision in Portugal within its historical, political, and geographical context, so as to expose their systemic, sector specific, and territorial differentiating dimensions. It explicitly endeavored to transcend disciplines and their boundaries, organizing research on the basis of relevant questions to the case at hand. This favored the inclusion of different levels, scales, and units of analysis, and the consideration of very material and non-material explanatory variables, such as the interests and values that were favored by the ongoing process of financialization. It required the mobilization of various analytical tools, including the analysis of secondary data using statistical and cartographic techniques, the implementation of an online questionnaire, Smith structure interviews between political actors in central and local administration, real estate, stakeholders, tenants associations, experts, as well as to individuals with different housing situations. And we also conducted archival research on discourses relating to ownership in the political, in the dictatorship. The team comprised political economists, geographers, and other social scientists, and was happy to count with the support of Professor Ben Fine and Professor Samuel Albert as the project's consultants. Most of the project's results have already been published, but I would like to highlight the edit book, Nova Questão da Habitação em Portugal, to which most members of the team contributed to. And we are now happy to announce a new book that is being prepared and it's going to be published in 2020, titled Financialization in the European Periphery, Work and Social Cooperation in Portugal, which will include some of the presentations of today. Now moving to the conference, our proposal is to collectively reflect on recent developments in the financialized stage of contemporary capitalism, giving due account of aggregating across and within geographies. For this, we thought to open the debate to other themes and to other colleagues beyond the FinID team, with whom we have worked on the same and related issues. I'd like to mention here the Facebook project, the acronym for Financialization, Economy, Society and Sustainable Development, which was a 5-year project led by Professor Malcolm Sawyer from Leeds from 2011 to 2016, where many of us met and began working together. We're not going to be here today. So our idea for today is to broaden discussion of financialization with the focus on most pressing issues. And so we invite Ben Fine to give us a talk on economic and social reproduction in the age of financialization, that will address the varied ways in which finance penetrates different economic and social domains. We invited Manuel Albers to give a talk on uneven and combined financialization of housing, addressing its impacts across and within different countries. In the afternoon, we will focus on the Portuguese context. Nuno and I, but he will do all the talking because we're all missing a lot, so we want to listen to him. So we will give an account of the changing nature of semi-peripheral financialization in Portugal, pinning down not only the particular characteristics of financialization of this geography, but also of its dynamics and its changing dynamics. Jorge Malheiros, Catiel Silva and Marcos Correia will bring other scales of relational specialities into the debate by looking into the socio-spatial segregation trends in the Lisbon metropolitan area. José Caldas will look at the recent transformations in labor relations, in particular the persistent effects of internal devaluation, which will allow us to have a deeper understanding of the impacts of the financial crisis on both economic and social production. Finally, in the last session, we will discuss the policy implications of the diagnosis and analysis of developments. We'll be asking João Rodrigues, José Reis, Ricardo Faz Mamed and Teresa Barata Salgueiro what possibilities lie ahead of us. Are we condemned to deeper financialization? Or are there alternatives? If so, which are they? This discussion will be in Portuguese in an attempt to open the discussion to another academic. So this is the program for today. I'm sure we will learn a lot together, enjoy it, and get inspired for future critical work and all the political struggles lying ahead of us, because I think we all want change in a better world.